Hello, David Zaritsky for the Bond Experience. Welcome back. Look, depending on where you are, where you're from, your geography, you may not be able to travel, but there are a handful, and I mean a small amount of people out there that are allowing us to travel either virtually online or through the old noodle in reading books about travel locations. Now connect that type of an experience with good old James Bond and some of his locations, and you've got a recipe for excitement, a little bit of mayhem, and success. And that's what we're talking about today. This book right here that I have in my GoldenEye presentation for a very specific reason is On the Tracks of 007 Presents the Côte d'Azur. Now this is by SIMON FIRTH, forward by Gareth Owens, Sir Roger Moore's former PA, and it has a design by Martin Mulder. Few people that you probably know incredibly well. But why am I talking about this book today? Well, there are books and there are books. This is the latter. And what I mean by that is when I first received this, I thought, oh, this is going to be great. It's a book that's going to have some pictures of the locales of some of the Bond films like Never Say Never Again, like GoldenEye and Diamonds Are Forever. And this will be fun. It'll be a picture book. But I wasn't exactly correct. This is so much more than a picture book. This is about a man's odyssey. So SIMON FIRTH lived in the Côte d'Azur for some time. And this is a little bit of a biography, if you will, of his time there. Encounters with the locals, different places to eat, certain places not to go. How does he build relationships? How are some of the relationships have walls, either literally or even psychologically, put up to him as somebody who, well, may not belong in that particular locale? Yeah, this is a really good story. And that's what I wanted to focus on with this, because as I flip through this, you're going to see something. That something is really incredible images. There's a combination of images of both SIMON and what he took while he was there in the different Bond locations, as well as images of the corresponding shots from the movie. So this way you don't have to use too much of your imagination to truly understand how he captures these moments, not only telling you where they are, so it's not just a map, but truly, what was he experiencing as a Bond fan? And that's what I want to focus with this, because even though, and I'm going to read the back of this, James Bond has left his mark in such pantheons of beauteous geography is no surprise, but just what they are and in how many forms. This goes over so many different things. So it has obviously his, when he lived there in the summer of 2019, but he dissects and discusses the locations for Diamonds Are Forever, Never Say Never Again, GoldenEye, books, Roll of Honor, Forever and a Day, the residences of Sir Sean Connery, Sir Roger Moore, and David Niven, the Cannes Film Festival and the Carlton Intercontinental Hotel, and even discusses an unfinished 1958 version of Casino Royale and certain, and we love this, what if locations. Now, I don't want to give too much away because this is a good read. This is about 160 plus pages. It's not going to take you months and months. It's not War and Peace. But what it is something that moves along so quickly. Even the typical Bond fan moment of just having a dry martini and what's the mindset and what you're going to find. It's a little bit of a side effect, a bonus. Let's call it a bonus. Side effect, that's, David, don't say side effect during a pandemic. A nice bonus in this is that you're going to get seriously nostalgia vibes of how you feel about James Bond. And if you've ever visited a James Bond location, you're also going to hear and see that typical angst when you can't get to a certain place or something doesn't match. You're also going to get the celebration that happens when something does connect very well and you have a eureka moment. SIMON brings all of that out. And I dare say that between the visual and the copy and the content and just the wonderful nostalgia that this brings, you're going to love this. because I'm in the marketing business, I've got to talk about one other aspect that I was impressed with. Hold on, hold on. It's hardcover. When was the last time there was a hardcover book? What? When was the last time there was a slipcover on a book? What the hell is a slipcover? Show this to your kids that are under 27 and go, look, this is what a book looks like. This is called a dust cover. This is when we had dust back in the 1800s. What I'm saying is this is such a nice throwback, but it also makes an incredible collector's piece. And look, you know, Marshall's cover, I mean, you don't get better than that. It is art. So it's art form in copy, it's art form in visuals, and I'm highly recommending this. Look, I don't do a review and discussion on every book that I get or every book that I read, but this one moved me. This one truly moved me, and on top of that, it's by Simon and Martin, who I'm fans of. They're just great people, and I want to support them as well. So check it out. The link is below. I promise you're going to enjoy them. I think it is limited, so don't sit in your laurels too long and go visit the Côte d'Azur and go check out why on earth I put this display with this book with this discussion. Okay, this has been David Zaritsky for The Bond Experience. We'll see you real soon. Take care. Thanks for watching this episode. If you want to be up on the latest from The Bond Experience, just click on this subscribe and subscribe to our channel. You're going to get all the latest and greatest information, plus some exclusive content. And by the way, speaking of content, here's something especially for you, just because we know you. Talk to you soon.